Everybody, today we are going to see a next point, that is relation between arc and chord. Okay, relation between arc and chord. Already we have seen what is chord, what is arc. Okay, arc is the portion of circumference that we have seen in the introduction, and chord means a line segment which is joining on the circumference. Means here about these two figures we can say PQ is the chord of the circle, or RS is the chord of circle, and here PQ, this portion PQ, is the arc of this circle, as well as RS is the arc of this second circle. Okay, so on this basis we are going to see some properties which are related to relation between arc and chord. Okay, so from that, first property is property number one, that is, if two arcs of a circle are congruent, if two arcs of a circle or congruent circle also we can say, here we can include of a circle or congruent circle also we can congruent circles, okay, here we can use that, of a circle are congruent, their corresponding chords are equal, their corresponding chords are equal. Okay, see figure once again, if two arcs of a circle are congruent, okay, or congruent circle also we can use here. If suppose these two circles are congruent, congruent means what? What is the mean of congruent circles? Congruent circle means the radii of both the circles are equal. Okay, suppose radius of this is 5 cm and the radius of this circle is 5 cm, then both the circles are congruent. Okay, so that is congruent circle. So here it is given, see, radius of this circle is R and radius of this circle whose center is O dash, its circle's radius is R, also R, means both the circles are congruent. Okay, so here what is given? If two arcs of a circle or congruent circle are congruent, then their corresponding chords are equal. Corresponding chords are equal means about these two circles, arc PQ is equal to or congruent arc RS, that is given. Okay, so that we will mention in the given things. So in given, in circle C, circle C O R and C O dash R. Okay, two circles are there. The first center is O and second circle center is O dash. Okay, radius of both circles is R, that is same. Chord PQ and RS. Chord PQ and RS are given. And what is given here? Arc PQ. Arc PQ congruent arc RS. Okay, with the help of this sign we have to show arc. Okay, so arc PQ congruent arc RS, that is given. This arc PQ and arc RS are equal, that is given. What is this sign suggest? This arrow means what? Why this arrow is given? Because now we are using PQ means it will go anti-clockwise. I told you, okay, before this. This is anti-clockwise. So we have to consider P to Q. Okay, if QP is given, then what will come? Anti-clockwise from Q to P. Okay, like that we need to think. So PQ arc, we need to write only PQ, not QP. QP means this arc will come. Okay, from Q is the first initial point and P is the last point, like that it will come. Okay, so for this arrow is given. Okay, if arrow is not given, then too we have to consider anti-clockwise direction. Okay, so here see what we have to show: chord PQ and chord RS are equal. Okay, chords are equal, that is our target. So in proof we have to show chord PQ is equal to chord RS. Okay, so construction we have done here. I have done first only, but construction we need to mention. Only chord is given and arc is given. Okay, so we need to join this PQ with the center. Okay, so that construction we need to mention. So in construction we will write join OQ O dash R and
and O dash S. Okay, this we need to join.
This is construction. So after construction, you will get this figure. Triangle you will get, arc you will get like this. Okay, what is given here? Arcs are equal. Okay, so here this I am showing with red pen. These arcs are equal. And we have to show PQ and RS. These are the chords that are equal. That is our target that we need to show. Okay, with the help of given things. So now when you will join, that time you will get two triangles. Okay, but there are two conditions. There are two conditions. What is first condition? When arc PQ is minor arc and when arc PQ is major arc. Both the conditions are possible. Okay, PQ is minor arc. Okay, minor means smaller than larger. Two arcs will come. Okay, getting everybody? See, this is circle, and if I will consider this to this, then this will be minor arc, and this arc will be major arc. So two arcs can come. So PQ, now in first, PQ is the minor arc. So first condition we will consider. So case first and case second, both the ways we need to solve. So in proof, here two proof and here proof will come. Proof, case first when PQ and RS, when PQ and RS, RPQ and RS are minor arc. So for this we will use first figure, this figure. Okay, so when these are the minor arc and when you will join this with the center PO, OQ, O dash R and O dash S, okay, that time you will get two triangles. Okay, if we are able to prove both the triangles are congruent, then automatically PQ and RS are congruent, that we can say. Okay, so now see, in triangle first we will consider let arc PQ and arc RS are minor arcs. Okay, so when both the arcs are minor. Okay, what is the condition? When arcs are congruent, it sustained equal angle at the center. So this angle and this angle will be equal. When it is possible, when arcs are equal, that time it sustained equal angle at the center. Here arc PQ and arc RS are equal. That is given in the statement also. So they sustained equal angle at the center. So that angle we are going to consider in the proof. So here what is given? See, PO is the radius. This is radius. All these four sides are radius of the both circles, and that both all the radius are equal. Because it is given, understood, congruent circles are there. So here we can say in triangle POQ and triangle RO dash S, PO is equal to RO dash, first side, PO is equal to RO dash, okay. Then what is the reason for this? Radii of the congruent circle. Okay, so this is the first reason. Then second, POQ is equal to angle RO dash S, is equal to angle RO dash S. Why? Because arcs are equal. RPQ is congruent to arc RS. Okay, so equal arc subtend equal angle at the center. So due to that, these two angles are equal. And next, third side is this OQ. OQ is equal to O dash R. OQ is equal to O dash S. Okay, same reason, radii of the congruent circles. Okay, so here two sides and included an angle. Two sides and included angle are equal to the two sides and included angle of the another circle or another triangle, that time we can say both the triangles are congruent by SAS criteria. So we can see here triangle POQ congruent triangle RO dash S by SAS side angle set. Okay, so now if triangles are congruent, then we can say PQ and RS are equal by bisecticity, and both are the chords of both circle. Okay, so now we can say PQ is equal to RS. PQ is equal to RS by CPCT, corresponding parts of congruent triangle, and that only our target, that is we have to show chord PQ and chord RS are equal. Okay, so this we have seen when arcs are minor. Now we will see when arcs are major, when PQ and RS are major arc. Okay, so major arc means what is going to come. This is, suppose that circle, then PQ will come, P and here Q. Okay, and anti-clockwise means this. So this is the major arc, that time this is the minor arc. Arc QP is minor arc. Okay, so only that much is difference. So see carefully here, when arcs are minor, major, when, case second, when PQ, here what is given, arc PQ and arc RS are major arc, major arcs. Okay, when arc PQ and arc RS are major arc. Okay, so that time what we will do, when these are the major arc, so what is given, arc PQ, here it is given arc PQ, arc PQ is equal to or congruent is equal to arc RS, that is given already, understood. If arc PQ is equal to, so definitely we can say QP is equal. Okay, QP is equal to SR, QP is equal to SR, we can say with the help of this. Okay, so here QP, arc QP is equal to arc SR. Okay, if these two are equal, so definitely remaining part, because circles are congruent, so we can say remaining arc of both the circles are congruent. So here we can say QP is equal to SR. Understood? If QP and SR are equal, QP and SR are equal, it subtends equal angle at the center, that is one thing. So from first, from this we can say here QP is equal to SR. QP is equal to SR. If arcs are equal, then QP and SR are equal. So we can say PQ is equal to RS. Chord PQ is equal to chord RS. Understood? So this is very simple proof. See carefully, these properties are very much important. Okay. One more property we are going to see, which is the converse of this. Okay, see here. Our next property number 2, that is converse of property number 1. Okay, so see here, what is the property number 2? If two chords of a circle or of congruent circles are equal, then their corresponding arcs, minor, major or semicircular, minor, major or semicircular, are congruent. Okay, so see here, figures are given. Here actually one figure is enough, but for the explanation I have done this. Okay, so with the help of one figure, we can, one pair of these two circles, two congruent circle, we can explain whole theorem or whole property. Okay, so see here, what is given, if two chords of circle or of congruent circle are equal, if first we will think about this figure. Okay, here chords are equal, that is given. So first in given things we will write, in given chord PQ of circle COR and chord RS of this circle, chord RS of circle CO dash R. Okay, what is given? If two chords of a circle are equal, means these chords are equal. So PQ is equal, R equal.
are equal. Okay, so that is given.
Then their corresponding arcs. Corresponding arcs means major arc, minor arc, major arc and semicircular are congruent. Okay, we have to prove corresponding arc. Means if we are thinking about this figure, then which is the corresponding arc? Arc PQ is congruent to arc RS. That we need to prove. Okay, so to prove arc PQ, congruent arc, RS. Okay, so that is our target. This we need to prove. Okay, so for this we need to do some construction. When it is diameter, PQ and RS are diameter, that time construction is not necessary. But when PQ and RS are not diameters, means when PQ and RS are minor arc and major arc, that time construction is necessary. See here, PQ is minor arc and RS is also minor arc. That time we need to join PO, OQ, O dash R and O dash S. Okay, so that time construction is necessary. So I am not writing here now. Okay, directly we can consider proof. Okay, but we need to mention, if you want to mention, then we need to write that when PQ and RS are diameters, that time construction is not necessary. But when PQ and RS are minor arc and major arc, that time join OP, OQ, O dash R and O dash S. Okay, the same procedure will come. Only the position of this PQ and RS will be different. But PQ and RS are equal, that is given. Okay, so in proof, first we will think about case 1. That is, first we will see this. When PQ and RS are the semicircles, PQ and RS are the diameters. When PQ and RS are the diameters, that time diameters, these are the diameters of equal radii. Radius are same, that is given, of equal radii. So definitely what is going to come? So definitely PQ and RS are congruent, we can say. Okay, see here, PQ and RS are the diameters of equal radii because both the circles are congruent. So we can say this is the arc PQ or QP. PQ is congruent to arc RS, that we can see very easily. So this is, in short, we can write, so arc PQ congruent arc RS. Okay, so here see figure, this arrow is important. Okay, arrow is important. When I want to say here PQ, arc PQ, that time P is the initial point and Q is the ending point. So that time I need to write PQ. If I will say QP, then Q is the first point and it will come like this, anti-clockwise. We cannot consider this way. Okay, it is anti-clockwise. Understood? So if I want to show RQP, that time it will come like this. Okay, so PQ means P to Q and QP means Q to P. Okay, so now this is case 1, that is, we have done this. When these arcs are or chords are diameter, that time. Now we will see case second. In case second, what we are going to see? We will see this. When PQ and RS are minor arc. Okay, when arc PQ and arc RS are minor arcs. Okay, when these are minor arcs, that time what we are going to see? We need to join this O, P, O, Q, O dash R and O dash S. Okay, so you will get here, see, these are the PQ and RS are equal, that is given. So we will think about these two triangles. We will think about triangle. In triangle, OPQ and triangle O dash RS. What is given? OP and OQ are the radius, and here also O dash R and O dash S are radius of the same circle. Okay, so here about these two triangles, we can say OP is equal to O dash R. Okay, OP is equal to O dash R. Also, we can say OQ is equal to O dash S. OQ is equal to O dash
S. Okay. Why? What is the reason? Because radii of the congruent circle. Circles are congruent. Radii of the congruent circles. Okay. Then we can say here PQ and RS are equal. That is given. PQ is equal to RS. What is the reason? It is given. So by side we can say triangle OPQ congruent triangle O dash RS by SSS. By side we can say both the triangles are congruent. If triangles are congruent, then we can say POQ, this angle POQ and this PRO dash S are equal. Okay, why? Angle POQ is equal to angle RO dash S by CPCP, corresponding angles. Okay, corresponding part of congruent triangles. Okay, these two triangles are congruent, so these are O and O dash are the corresponding angles. Understood? And both are equal by CPCT, we can say here. And if these two angles are equal, then subtended by them, which arcs are there, both the arcs are equal, we can say. Understood? Because equal angles subtend equal angles, equal arcs. So from this we can say RPQ congruent arc RS. Okay, so here RPQ and arc RS are equal. Okay, so this is case number 2. Now we will see case number 3. Case third. What is case number 3? When RPQ and arc RS, RPQ and arc RS are major arc. Okay, this time, this figure you can see, RPQ, this is major arc. That time what is going to come? RQP is the minor arc and arc SR is also minor arc. Okay, when RPQ and RS are major arcs, that time what is going to come? QP, RQP and arc SR are minor arcs. Okay, so we can say QP is equal to SR, RQP is equal to RSR. Okay, RQP is equal to RSR. Okay, but what is given here? It is given that PQ and RS are equal. PQ and RS are equal. Okay, suppose I want to show here QP, this if I want to show here QP, I want to represent, then how I can write? 360 degree minus this arc, 360 degree minus arc PQ. So I am taking that QP, I will represent 360 degree minus arc major arc PQ. Okay, is equal to, if SR I want to show, SR, this arc I want to show, then here also 360 degree minus arc RS, major of arc RS. Okay, so here 360 we can cancel, minus sign will be cancelled, so major of arc PQ is equal to major of arc RS, major of arc RS. So from that we can say RPQ is congruent arc RS. RPQ and RS are congruent. So in the three cases, all the three cases, first case number 1, case number 2 and case number 3, all the three cases we got the same result, that is RPQ and RS are congruent. Okay, so this is the property number 2, which is very much important, we are going to use in sums. This is the property number 2, is the converse of property number 1. Okay. Okay, see here, our first example depend on the same concept, relation between arc and chord. Okay, so see here, first example, in figure, arc AB congruent arc AC, O is the center of circle, prove that OA is the perpendicular bisector of BC. OA is the perpendicular bisector of BC, that we need to prove.
Okay. So first we will think about what is given. We have what is given? Arc AB congruent arc AC. That is given. Arc AB and AC are equal. That is given. So if arcs are equal, then equal arcs subtend equal chords. Okay. So we can say AB is equal to AC. AB is equal to AC. Getting everybody? This is property. Arc AB and arc AC are equal. So both arcs are subtending AB and AC chords respectively. So both the chords will be equal. Okay. So here we can say AB is equal to AC. AB and AC are equal. Okay. So now if we are thinking about this AO. AO is the bisector of angle BAC. Why AO is the bisector of angle BAC? Because see here, what is given? And O is the center of circle. O is the center of circle. Okay. And O, it remains on the bisector of AC. We have seen one theorem. Okay. You can refer that theorem. Understood. So now here we can say AO is the bisector. AO is the bisector. What we have to prove? We have to prove perpendicular bisector. AO is the bisector of angle BAC. AO is the bisector of angle BAC. So now if it is bisector, then we can say BAO is equal to angle CAO. Okay. So this is, I am saying this is first one. This is, I am saying first one. And this we will say second one. Okay. So now we will think about these two triangles. These two triangles. Okay. So in triangle AMB, in triangle AMB and triangle AMC, what is given? AB is equal to AC. AB and AC are equal. We said here AB is equal to AC. Okay. Then BAO means what? BAM. We can write angle BAM. BAO, we can write BAM is equal to angle CAM. Okay. So this is, we can say from second. Okay. AB is equal to, we can say from one. Then AM is the common side for both the triangles. AM is the common side for both the triangles. So here we can write AM is equal to AM. Okay. So two sides and one angle, included angle, two sides and included angle are equal to the corresponding angles. So here we can say by side angle side, by SAS criteria, we can say triangle AMB congruent triangle AMC by SAS, by side angle side, both the triangles are congruent. Okay. If triangles are congruent, we can say angle AMB is equal to angle AMC. This angle and this angle is equal because corresponding angle. So here by CPCT we can give reason. By CPCT both the angles are congruent. Okay. What is our target? What we have to prove? Perpendicular bisector. Perpendicular means we need to show this angle, these angles AMB and AMC are 90 degree. That time it is perpendicular. And bisector, AO is the bisector only. Okay. So if these two angles are equal and they are forming linear pair. So here we can say angle AMB plus angle AMC is equal to 180 degree. Okay. So here I am saying this is third one. So from third we can take here angle AMB plus angle AMB is equal to 180 degree. So two times angle AMB is equal to 180 degree. So angle AMB is equal to 90 degree. AMB is equal to 90 degree. Okay. So this is 90 degree. And this also 90 degree. Okay. So both the angles are 90 degree means we can say here AO is the perpendicular bisector. Prove that OA is the perpendicular. So OA is the perpendicular bisector of BC. Okay. And BC is equal to
BC. BC is equal to CM. Here we can see BC. Here we need to write that BC is equal to CM. This is also by CPCT, same reason. Okay, perpendicular bisector means it makes the two parts. Got it, everybody? Solve the same properties in your notebook and this example and given worksheet which is depend on this concept. Okay.